we are facing the serious challenge right now. But since Indonesia got independent, somehow we have capital to protect our unity and to make sure that we still stand on the foundations that our founding fathers have inherited to us, such as the principles of freedom of the religion itself, as the expressions of our the first principle of religiosity in Indonesia. So we are not exclusive, so we embrace the inclusive ideology that state, the duty of the state is to make sure that every citizen can embrace and also practice whatever the religions they want to. So we have hundreds of religions right now. And we took it from our old practice back to 17th century, when one kingdom, the big kingdoms in Indonesia, also allow the same rooms for Shiva and also for Buddhists. So it is in our DNA, the freedom for religions, actually. And especially also our constitution is really clear stated that the freedom for religions are protected in Indonesia in the Article 29. Of course, because we are leaders, and every political party also must prepare the leaders that later on will contest it in the elections. And the duty of political party is first not only to supply the progressive politicians, but also to transform society from the anti-equality to pro-equality, or from corrupt society to anti-corruption and etc. Including this matter that leader must pro for freedoms for religions. And it is really the message and also our duty to uphold the Pancasila. The first principle of Pancasila is really freedom for religions.